The program is presented by Railers, Bisnode, Screenbolaget, Utevärdshus.
Otillo, which means island to island in Swedish, is held in the Stockholm archipelago always on the first Monday of September.
This is the toughest day race in the world and probably one of the toughest races you can do.
From dawn to dusk, teams of two run and swim up to 75 kilometers.
You never know. Maybe we'll finish, maybe not.
I mean, it's something different. I've heard since the day I moved here to Sweden, I've had friends tell me, you know, you got to try this race.
The race course starts in front of Sirglar Hotellet in Sandhamn. It finishes 75 kilometers and 26 islands later in front of Utevärdshus on Öta.
We applied for this because we like challenges. That's why, you know, we like swimming, running, and doing things together. So why not?
Imagine 1.5 Ironman runs in your wetsuit and 3 Ironman swims in your running shoes. Swimrun racing is a new and growing sport out of Sweden, and Otillo is the original swimrun race and can be considered as the world championship.
We both individually heard about the race separately. We talked about it separately and then we decided to do it together.
Well, I mean, it's completely unique. I mean, you're not going to get a race like this anywhere else, and it's, you know, it is one of the endurance challenges in the world to do.
Swimrun racing is here to stay. The fastest team on the first swim is last year's third-place finishers, Team Nidrovik and Rib, with Simon Borgeson and Rasmus Ragnarstrand. This year's Otillo has record speeds. Here at the swim entry of one of the most feared passages of the race, the very difficult 1,400-meter swim almost midway through the course, we clock the leaders almost 30 minutes ahead of the times of previous years.
The time that people have, or that teams have finished a race in, have really decreased over the last 3 years. And I think part of it is that people understand more about how the race is done. And also they train specifically for Otillo. And I think that is basically how times will actually go down a little bit more. But I really don't think we'll come down more than 45 minutes ever again.
It now seems as if teams 9, 1, and 3 are moving the fastest and will fight each other for the Otillo title. The course section now changes character to a more difficult terrain with no trails over cliffs and rock. Up at the final hill towards the finish line and Utevärdshus, Team 9, Bjorn Englund and Paul Krochak of Team Head Swimming are the champions of Otillo 2013. Crushing the previous record with 32 minutes and with the incredible time of 8 hours and 35 minutes.
Yes! We said we're gonna have fun. We did have fun. We're gonna get tired. We got tired. And we wanted to have a good place finish. And we won. Couldn't have asked for more. I'm so happy. Oh, I'm so happy.
That was really tough.
Yeah.
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, it's been such a long journey to get here. We started training, I mean, probably at the end of October last year. And you wonder when this race is going to come, and finally it gets here. And you just feel good, and it just feels so good to win this thing.
Yeah.
Feels worth it totally.
Team number one, Lelle Moberg and Magnus Olander. Team Lisk Valatia by Ika Hagsatra. Last year's winners crossed the line in second place, 7 minutes after the winners, and also well under the previous course record. Simon and Rasmus, third yet again, in 8 hours and 49 minutes, also under the previous course record. Best mixed team, 2-on-2 Friedrich Selmerit and Annika Eriksson, also a new course record. Awesome mother and daughter, Charlotta Nielsen and Bibben Nordblom, hold their lead and win the women's category, also in record-breaking time. While the top teams battled it out, many teams are struggling very hard to just finish the race. The absolute last teams are exiting the water for the last time on Utah after almost 14 hours of racing. Only a couple of kilometers are left before they finally can rest and celebrate the fact that they finished Otillo, a dream come true.